We continue our knowledge sharing mission through a series of interviews with leaders from all over the world, and are thrilled to have Dennis with us today. Hello, Dennis.
Hi, Roman. And I'm Dennis Wakabayashi. I'm the Chief Collaboration Officer at Team Wakabayashi. We are a consultancy or an agency, if you will. There's about 60 of us, and we work on four different continents to bring customer experience around the world.
Can you give a one-sentence description of your company?
We're a team of 60 experts focused on business transformation, and we start on the topic of customer experience, and we help leaders learn about journey mapping, figure out how to do integrated planning, and then we support them on the back end.
Can you describe the role of a global marketing influencer in one word and why?
Collaborator, because in order to be an influencer, you know, that's a broad term, but I think we're more collaborators of the community. We strive to bring the stories and the voices of the community to the public. So we're really all about tapping into what's great about other people and taking that forward. So collaborator.
What current challenges are global marketing influencers facing right now? Can you identify a solution?
The largest challenge, I think, today is staying relevant in a global content marketplace. You know, the pandemic brought around a lot of new voices and all valid voices. So I think what we strive to do in terms of maybe the challenge and opportunity is find partnerships or relationships that can amplify the messages that we find relevant for the community. And so that's what we focus on. I think the biggest solution that I found is to team up with people like yourselves and share knowledge. So thanks for having me.
How do you explain the success you've had in your career?
Oh, that's easy. It's teamwork. We're called Team Wakabayashi. I didn't choose the Team Wakabayashi part of it. It was just something that came together because we all have this like-mindedness and this good energy and good vibes. And we bring that in everything we do. And I think I just get the benefit of sort of being the spokesperson for everyone.
Can you tell us about a time you took a major risk in your career?
Starting Team Wakabayashi, it sounds kind of trite, but it has been the biggest risk in my career. And the reason is our model is built on an observation of the marketplace, a world in which we have hybrid workers, a global workforce. And so we price ourselves at a global level. So where we find our counterparts in the US, as an example, maybe charging $200, $250 per hour, we're still around $50 an hour because we have great minds from all kinds of different economies. So we keep our prices fair to everyone on the team. I think that was a huge risk because so many people said, Dennis, you could charge so much more. But I think what my risk was thinking, really, because if we're being honest, great minds, great voices, doing good work, it doesn't have to be all about the money. So I guess the big risk is doing this for more than money.
What marketing or business trends are you taking advantage of right now?
First of all, you know, the number one trend in marketing and in the ecosystem in terms of profitability is a shift to e-commerce. So of course, we're looking at e-commerce trends, what's happening around the world. The other trend that is really important to pay attention to is this global marketplace. We see offshore, BPO, a lot of different models now taking advantage of brilliant minds from everywhere in the world and bringing them together. So I think the trend is not to let your smartest people come from a particular geography, not to have that bias, but to take advantage of the communication tools that are available to tap into rich resources, human resources around the world.
What career advice would you like to share with global marketing influencers?
I would say that consistency is key, having an original voice. And the irony of that, I would quote another person speaking about originality, but there was a famous rapper in the United States, and he said, "Copycats finish last in the human race." And I think that's true.
Right. I think this brings us to a close. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, and I'm looking forward to the next catch-up.
Thank you so much, Roman.